am off to film New Heights Academy's show in the Furness Theatre in Llanelli. New Heights is run by David and Rebecca, a lovely couple who basically started New Heights only a few years ago. I think it was about just before lockdowns and all the COVID stuff started. So it's them been going long, but the shows are amazing and they're so lovely with children as well. There's so much talent in that school. I've got very high expectations for today. And obviously being in Furness, Furness is lovely theatre. It's quite modern theatre for those who've never been to the Furness. I think most of the theatres nowadays are sort of shying away from the traditional listed building. Quite strange, whenever I'm in the Defender, the way people stare. I literally feel like I'm a goldfish in a ball and people are just staring, or animal in a zoo. You know the gorillas that are in a cage and people come and just stare at them and the gorillas turn their back. It's just like, leave me alone, stop looking. That's me. Such a beautiful day today, and it's so nice not to have to wear a mask. And last time I filmed New Heights, it's strange because they were literally the last show, the day before the country went into a lockdown with COVID and everything, and so New Heights was literally the last show I filmed the night before it. I never forget coming back. Nobody knew what to expect with all the lockdowns and everything. And I remember thinking, I've got no food in the fridge. Literally my food fridge is empty. I can't get a takeaway because all the takeaways are shut. So I stopped by Spar just in Calais, we just went past it. Literally there was nothing other than sweets and chocolates on the shelves. All the cans had gone, all the pasta had gone, all the rice had gone. I had my pass, this pass, which is Furness Theatre pass, it gets me in. And they must have thought I was a doctor or something because I was in a suit. And the guy said, hang on a minute, let me go around the back, see what I've got for you. Because I said to the guy, look, I've got no food. We've gone into a lockdown. God knows when I'm going to be able to get all the food again. So he said, let me go around the back. He came back with a packet of rice. And I thought, oh, thank God, at least I've got rice. So I ate rice for next 2-3 days. So rationed small portions until I could get some proper food. But what we went through was crazy. So it's quite a strange feeling coming back to the theatre to film New Heights. I think I did another show after that for them as well, after that very last show before the lockdown. I can't remember now. But yeah. So I've got really strange memory of that day, and especially New Heights Academy being Furness Theatre, the very last show, and now going back again. I'm pretty certain I filmed for them once after that as well. I'm pretty certain I did. I filmed so many shows, I can't remember. Every time I go past that, I say to myself, I need to go in there and support the farmers, because these big supermarkets, as much as they're convenient, they don't really help the farmers directly at all. If anything, a lot of farmers lose money from what I heard. Because when there was, when big supermarkets were claiming there's no vegetables available, and they were saying, oh, it's because of Brexit, and which is partially true, but oh, it's because of Brexit, or because of this, because of that. The reality was the farmers came on TikTok and social media and they said, no, it's all lies. It's only because we're losing money. With the price of electricity gone up, literally to run the greenhouses and grow the vegetables and everything, we are literally losing money. And these big supermarkets announcing huge profits, and they're not passing any of that on to the farmers, so they can at least break even, if nothing else.
So
that's why I try now, as much as I can, I try and shop directly with farmers' shops, so at least they benefit from it directly, rather than have to give their money to big supermarkets who don't care. A few days ago, I looked everywhere for my GoPro, and the one I always put on the outside of the car, just couldn't find it. I just thought, oh, what if I've left it in a theater? So I looked everywhere, couldn't find it. So I bought a new one, the GoPro 11, and I thought, do you know what? It doesn't matter. I need to make these vlogs for my future self, so basically I know I can look back on and I know what happened. I know some of these videos are made in the past, and I look back on them and the memories just come flooding back. That's why I wish I'd done these vlogs going back years ago. Especially when I used to do events, because that would have been, I mean, that was just amazing with all the lights and the guests all dressed up, and you know, the entertainments were always fantastic, the awards were amazing. I wish I was doing vlogs back then, so I at least have memories of it to look back on. This road in summer is so beautiful, so beautiful. Whenever I go long distances, when I say long distances, like from Swansea to Netley, because quite often I work around Swansea area, and when I go outside the Swansea, I always pretend in my head, I always feel like I'm going on a holiday or journey, a long journey, especially when the road's really nice like this. I think to myself, oh, I'm driving south of France, so. We're gonna come up to a beautiful river. Again, I don't know whether this is a river or what it is, but it's a sort of bit of water and a bridge over it. It must be a river, but it's so scenic. I hope the water is this. I don't know if you can see it. We're now going over this bridge. On the left-hand side is the train track that goes over it. So when the water is high, I don't know what's it must be a river. It must be. When the water is high, it's really nice. Really nice. You can see why I love this road. It's so scenic. years ago, I went to West Wales to do a corporate shoot. And it was for an oil company called Oil for Wales. And the road, I don't know where in West Wales it was. It was somewhere. It took me about 2 hours to get there. But the road was so scenic. So scenic. Talking of Oil for Wales, I literally had an email from them. I got a meeting with them to make a TV advert, another TV advert for them. I came down to Furness Theatre yesterday to watch the show, gauge where everything is so I can work out the camera angles and everything. And this road was jam-packed. It took me an hour and a half to go from Swansea to Netley. So a journey that normally takes half an hour took me an hour and a half. And then when I got there, I found out there was a really bad accident on M4 on the motorway. So everybody had diverted to this road. No wonder there was cars back to back. Days like this, I actually wish I had a motorbike. Do you know, ever since I was little, I loved having a motorbike, but it scares me. Oh, vintage car. Nice. They actually last forever. They were built to last forever. Cars nowadays are not built like that. I think it's the reason cars don't last forever, or anything for that matter, plastic bags, they're designed to disintegrate to make them more green, basically. So that's why you see old cars that's still about, but modern cars, they rust away and disintegrate basically after a while. Well, I've just seen Bridget. She runs Seren Theatre Company. Such a lovely lady, and her children are so talented. Right, I'll sign out and I'll see you all shortly. So this is the beautiful Furness Theatre, absolutely gorgeous. How are you, lovely? You okay?
You okay?
I'm excited. So we're in the main theatre today, and I'll show you the main theatre in a minute. I've got the whole of balcony to myself, which is unusual for me. That's where the sound desk is. Hello!
Well, that can be okay with the pipers.
Yeah, it's too far away, it'd be fine. Yeah, it'd be fine, it'd go straight up.
Yeah, most of the dust goes straight back down to the floor, so...
Yeah, it'd be fine. Thank you. So what James was saying, he was worried about one of the cameras being too near the pyros, and obviously with the pyros going off, He was worried that the canal might be damaged. But this is what I mean about how lovely they are in this theatre. You know, it's literally like a big family. Everybody looks out for everyone. So just finished the matinee and waiting to film the 5:30 evening show. Just going to change the battery. About 2 months ago I came here. There's this lock. They lost the key to it. And everyone was panicking because the show was starting and basically everybody wanted ice cream because it was really hot and nobody could find it. Eventually they managed to find their key, but yeah. So this is what their children see when they're on stage, all these people watching. But saying that, most of them can't see the audience because up there you've got spotlights that are quite bright and obviously the theatre's dark, so I don't think they actually get to see the audience because they're blinded by the spotlights. Not blinded, but the spotlights in their eyes, so yeah. It's a gorgeous theatre, absolutely stunning. Amazing! It's just a case of it's all mine. It's all mine.
I'm jumping in. I'm boiling.
Oh, sweet. So you're the witch.
Yeah.
Just put them on your top and then yeah.
Were you the witch at the matinee as well? Oh, you're amazing. Oh, do you know, you're actually proper scary. Can I just say that?
I've been told a lot.
This sweet people, this sweet, lovely girl has got a really scary side to her.
Tom saw my jiggly ball.
So what's the significance of the stickers? Because I've seen other girls. Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow, like that. So what's the significance of the stickers then?
Oh, we just put stickers and decided to give it to everyone.
Oh, wow. Does it hurt when you put it? Like, does it get itchy? You don't feel anything?
It's a little bit itchy.
It does get
wow.
And how do you wash it off then?
Water. Yeah, use water.
Oh, so it'll just come off easier.
Make it remover. I tend to use a bit of that to help.
You were amazing! You were amazing! You were amazing! Honestly, incredible.
Thank you.
Thank you for filming.
No, honestly, you were... When you came on stage, honestly, all of you, I just love the way you change character, the way you change personalities. You're not, because you, when you're in real life, you're like really sweet and friendly, happy. But when sweetest ever. Yeah. But oh my God, when she's on stage, I zoomed in on her. She's proper scary.
She is.
She is proper.
She's scary anyway.
She's scary anyway.
No, she's not. She's a sweetheart.
No, she's not.
Ah, this is behind the scene.
Behind the scene.
Behind the scene YouTube. Emily's done a big heart for you.
I saw this on
Who's done there? Who's that? Somebody has done a proper like art in the back of you. It's a work of art.
A bit of art.
So proud of you. I'll see you on stage. Who's Dorothy?
Kira's
Dorothy
today.
All right.
I'm Scarecrow.
Oh, wow.
I'm just in that, if you can't tell.
Okay, of course, of course. And that was Dorothy in the matinee. Dorothy. Proud of you all. Take care. Can I just tell everyone on YouTube how you're a traitor to the cause? This guy, he was my twin. I had a twin. And he decided to betray me and grow his hair.
2 days, it was back.
Did real quick.
2 days. Do the worst thing is...
30 years I've tried to grow it back, and it's not...
Do the worst bit is, I've had a shave since then as well.
Oh yeah, you used to have a proper long beard.
Oh, that went the same time as that. That all went the same time. But,
you didn't do the eyebrows, did you?
Huh? No, I kept the eyebrows. Kept the eyebrows.
For now.
Look like Mr. Potato Head, otherwise.
Nicest guy ever. Nicest guy. Both of these, honestly.
Best crow here. Just a shitty boy, born and raised in South Detroit. This is so cool. Hi.
Are you in this show or were you in the last one?
I'm in both of them. I was
of course.
I go across. I'm talking to my future self. Hi.
Dorothy!
Oh, I hate to
guys,
think of
what
Dory
song
getting
should we sing?
Dress.
What song should we sing for? What song should we sing for our future selves? We built this city. We built this city on rock and roll. Damn.
Not it.
I want to audition for Ariel.
Oh, nice.
Who are you auditioning for, Willard?
That's the one.
Tom Tiffin, the one with the glasses, yeah. Auditioning for Wren.
Oh, brilliant. When will you know who's who?
Oh, I don't know. We haven't even said what we're doing.
No, of course we don't.
We hope so.
Oh, proud of you.
Can someone?
You're gorgeous, Tan. Wow.
Sunny.
Spent all day outside.
Sunny, spent all day in the theatre.
Oh, bless. Honestly, everyone's so happy. You could see, oh wow, look at the makeup. That looks amazing.
Little doggy.
Bye. What are you?
Yeah, that's fine.
What's
you
your role?
Toaster.
What? You
the
are?
Dog.
The dog. Oh my god.
Hello.
Were you the dog earlier?
No.
Oh.
No, a dog.
Okay. Hello.
Do you want to sign my script?
Oh god, that's...
I need you to sign my script as well. Simon did, and Wayne.
Here we go, lovely.
You.
Okay.
Do you want to see the process of putting on a mic?
Go on, Dad.
So you put it on the back of the ears.
It's tangled.
You pop it on the back
Lock
of the ears.
Yeah.
Oh, we can't have that.
Do you know, it's fine. In years to come, you're going to watch this and go, oh, this is how it used to go.
Right, do you know how to do it? That's upside down. Right, Noah doesn't know where to put a mic on. Can you shove this?
Noah, do you know the bits that look like ears, Noah? You put them on my ears.
Right, Noah, just hold my hair.
There you go, I've put it on.
No, you have not. Yes. It's on, but he barely did it. And then...
Emily.
And then you just like...
I'm not filming that! So I've just finished filming the New Heights Academy show, and it was incredible. But do you know what I loved about New Heights was the fact that all the pupils were so friendly, so lovely, so down to earth. There was no egos, there was no hierarchy as you see in some theatre companies. There was no malice. there's no rivalries, there's no negative emotions of any kind. It's just one big friendly family. It's lovely, so lovely. And you could see how much the kids loved it. Absolutely loved being part of this. So, yeah. And Rebecca and David are just so nice. I'm exhausted, but I love it. I love working in Furness. Yeah, the show was quite a short one, relatively speaking, as it was a junior's version. So it was hour and a half, about an hour and 15. Days like this are really hard for me because they're really long. It could be a lot longer because sometimes shows are 2.5 hours long with the interval, sometimes 3 hours with the interval. So I get up early in the morning, about 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock, to get everything ready to leave home, to be here at 10, to start packing, to start setting up the cameras and everything. And it's really hard when you've got a whole day work, two shows back to back, because you end up between the matinee and the evening performance, you end up going to Subway, that's just opposite, or Iceland for junk food, you know, sweets, chocolates, because you're starving.